We present tangent space optimization for interactive animation control. Character animation consists in defining key poses that are interpolated over time. If the interpolation does not match the artist's vision, all they can do is either add more key poses or manually modify the tangents of each attribute of each control, which is extremely not intuitive. Furthermore, the interpolation changes if elements are animated in forward or inverse kinematics. That imposes a binary choice to the user and limits their interaction to the set of available IK chains. The system we propose abstracts the consideration of FK versus IK and the hierarchy of controllers. It provides control on the interpolation of any part of the body through a space-time curve interface. During manipulations, our solver optimizes for the tangents of animated attributes. No keys are added, which permits the user to keep using traditional tools if desired. The blue structure is an abstraction of the character's controls we drive and their connections. Each sphere corresponds either to skeleton joints, rig controls, or any other representation that the artist chooses to use. It could also represent only part of the controls for local editing. For a more natural character response, properties can be specified to each joint or read directly on the rig. Angle limits are used to limit rotations, such as for not breaking elbows and knees. Stiffness defines how much a joint resists to rotation. For example, the clavicle usually rotates less than the shoulder when the arm is moving. The user can select any part of the structure to see its trajectory over time. If desired, that trajectory can be seen in local space with respect to another joint. Then, they can manipulate the curve in order to edit the point's trajectory. Orientations over time can also be visualized and edited. When pinning points in red, the user constrains them to keep the same trajectory and orientations over time. When a parent of the manipulated element is pinned in the hierarchy of controllers, our solver optimizes for attributes up to that joint only. If a child is pinned, attributes in the descendant chain will also be modified in order to compensate for the parent's modifications. More constraints can be added directly on the curve for finer editing. Once again, no keys are added during manipulations. Instead, the tangents of interpolation are optimized. A joint can also be set as contact to ensure that it will not move during a certain time range. Finally, we also provide control on the timing of the interpolation by scaling up and down the distance between frames. The closer together frames are, the slower the motion is, and vice versa. In the static case, our representation and optimization can be used to manipulate the pose of the character in a pin and drag manner without conflicting with the traditional workflow. This accentuates the fact that no IK chain is required when using our system. We now show results generated with our system. Playing guitar is generally one of the most challenging animations to create because of the unusual fingers gestures and contacts. But the interaction becomes very natural using our pin space system. Here are the key poses designed by an artist. Since the interpolation is made on rotations, we by default notice an important sliding on the fingers. We thus specify contacts at the right time ranges. We edit other unnatural interpolations. And here is the result we obtain. Those 10 key poses were designed to create a diving animation. The default interpolation contains foot sliding, round trajectory, and unnatural timing. Here is the edited interpolation using our tool. We show some steps of the editing process. Our system is not limited to human models, it can also be used to manipulate any type of character, like this spider robot. Here, we use only two key poses that were then looped to create a walk cycle. Here is the default interpolation. And here is the edited version. Finally, we show a dinosaur punching animation. There, the contact between the ground and half of the tail is very specific and would be difficult to achieve with traditional systems. For comparison, we asked professional animators to create the same animations using traditional tools in Maya. It came out that in average, they required more than twice more keyframes than with our tool. Also, since they were using some IK interpolations, the rig evaluation was 40% slower. We also conducted a user study to evaluate how our system can fasten animation editing. We asked users to edit this simple robot flying animation in order to avoid the obstacles. We compared the time required to achieve this task using traditional tools in Maya and using our system. We observed not only that the process is faster with our approach, but also that it yields smoother and more appealing results. Thank you for your attention.